Malcolm Turnbull is heading into 3 days of Parliament looking to win support for tax cuts on personal income and big businesses. Labour doesn't support corporate tax cuts or the second half of the income tax cuts, but the government is taking a hard line. "We are committed to securing the passage of a business tax cuts in full," Finance Minister Matthias Cormann told reporters on Monday. He also said the government will not split up the personal income tax cuts package, even though Labour does support sections of them. Monday's news poll showed the coalition's primary vote sitting at 38%, level with Labour's, while the government is behind 48-52 on the two-party preferred vote. But Mr. Turnbull gained 1 point to 47% as preferred Prime Minister, while Bill Shorten dropped 2 points to 30%, marking the longest net negative satisfaction rating of any opposition leader. The coalition got a boost with Tasmanian Independent Senator Steve Martin joining the Nationals on Monday, after feeling drawn to their views on rural and regional Australia. "That really fits with Tasmania and I think I fit with the Nationals," Senator Martin told reporters on Monday. The defection means the government is slightly closer to getting its tax cuts through the upper house, but it still has a battle. More than a third of voters surveyed said corporate tax cuts should come into effect as soon as possible, while a further 27% want them to be implemented over 10 years. Pauline Hanson has flip-flopped several times on the tax cuts, but now says voters can ring her office to get their message across. With 5 by-elections due on July 28, speculation has been rife the government might take their chances at a general election later this year rather than wait until it is due in early 2019. "I'm now thinking it is more likely they might be looking at an early election than even I thought a few weeks ago," Labour Senator Murray Watt told Sky News. The government will this week table new regulations allowing election candidates to declare they are eligible to sit. The lower house is expected to pass laws to put in place a redress scheme, stemming from the Child Abuse Royal Commission, while new penalties for dodgy live sheep exporters will also pass. With the Senate not sitting until June 18, budget estimates hearings will be held in Canberra. Treasury officials will be grilled on Tuesday, while hearings will also cover school and university funding, Medicare, welfare, defence, foreign affairs, industrial relations and small